She's always late. Her phone is continuously on vibrate, so she never picks the phone up when you ring her. She's got a personality like a box of chocolates. You never know which one you're going to get. And she loves a party. She's good fun. Girls, 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 girls.
I'm a bit of a shopaholic. It doesn't necessarily matter what I'm buying, it's just something new. I'm like a magpie. I love places like this. We're in Shoreditch today, generally because I'm not really from around this area. When I'm here, I love to come and look in like off-the-hook kind of shops. For me personally, if I'm accessorising a lot, then I tend to keep the dressing quite simple. I went to the Castellet polo match and I wore quite a simple CNC from my friend's boutique. Very simple kind of vest dress, long dress with a split down the side. But I teamed it up with some really chunky gold jewellery by Laura Bonnick, which was exactly the look I was going for. Never necklace and earrings together, I just think it's a bit too much. If it's more simple, then yeah, you could probably get away with a necklace, but don't do big earrings with big necklaces, it's just a big no-no. I love going to places like Topshop and high street shops and Selfridge. I like a bit of everything, but then I'll throw in the odd bit of designer thing, or I might have a designer pair of sunglasses or a designer pair of shoes. I very rarely buy a lot of designer clothes, and if I do, I always make sure it's a real classic, usually quite a nice classic black number or something that's not going to really just be in one minute and out the next, because I can't warrant spending that amount of money on something that's going to kind of be out of trend in the next season. I think you can overdo designer. If you're dressed head to toe in designer, I think it can look quite tacky. I'm really quite into shift dresses at the moment, kind of just where you don't feel like you're kind of really, like, say, imagine this dress without the belt on, it would probably be a little bit more maybe shapeless, but then I'd probably dress it up with a pair of earrings or whatever, because of my hairdo, I suppose. No one's amazing all the time, no one's perfect, and I think, especially, I suppose, with what we do, when we are going to get followed, it's always handy to have a pair of glasses with you, come rain or shine. I find a lot of designer sunglasses, they're usually really wide on my face. I think I've got quite a narrow head. I've got a bit of a pea head. I'm probably the most indecisive person you'll ever come across. I can stand there for hours deliberating what I should or shouldn't get. So I always make sure I've got a good, honest friend with me. No. I quite like these. They're a bit different. They're not actual Ray-Bans, but they're very similar. They actually probably suit me better than the actual Ray-Bans. So there you go. There's a prime example. You don't have to go for the name. So I think I'll be getting a pair of those. I love going shopping when I'm abroad, because you can also get some wicked stuff. I've got a wicked pair of glasses quite similar to these, which I bought in Melbourne. And they're still on the brink of death. They've been squashed a good few times and I'm trying to save them. And I've warned, I think it was Kimberly last time, she trod on them when we were on tour, and I could have killed her. My biggest tip about sunglasses is not to be afraid to be a little bit flamboyant. If it suits you or the outfit you're wearing, then just go for it. Don't be afraid to mix and match. I mean, if you want to feel a little bit special and get something pretty, like, amazing, then spend a bit of money, but make sure it's not something you're only going to wear once. So there's three, there's two. Being a girl, you can't just stop in one shop. It's time to move on to the next, so come with me. Pictured quite a lot out in these earrings. I bought them here last time we were doing. It was actually the Sun Silk advert we shot here, and I ended up taking away a few pieces with me. They're my most favourite accessory earring of the moment. So if you look back, you'll probably notice that I'm wearing them quite a lot. Big earrings like that, especially having short hair, yeah, probably would be more of a kind of 60s feel. It's just kind of the vibe that I'm going for at the moment. I love how everything eventually goes full circle. My mum will say to me, oh my God, if I'd have just kept those boots in the wardrobe, they could have been reused, you know. It's actually quite nice having something that's worn in and kind of old looking, that doesn't look too brand spanking new as well. I don't really have a particular style. I have
I just think if I like something, I see it, I can make it work to how I'd probably want it to work. I'm not really a typical dressy kind of girl. You know, you wouldn't see me flouncing about in a ball gown, naturally, anyway. But I've always been a little bit tomboyish. But then when I look like a lady, I know when to act like a lady. I have got a bit of a tendency to like really off-the-cuff jewellery and stuff, and there's a few bits over there. I'm scared to ask how much they are.
These are amazing. Really like these. You could be a winner.
Personally, it's more about what makes me feel comfortable. If I don't want to make an effort and I don't want to bother, if I'm just going down the local supermarket, I'll just throw a pair of trackies on and my boots. I'm not really too fussed. But if I'm going out somewhere nice for dinner or going out with some mates to a club, then of course I'm going to want to look nice.
All Tatty Divine, they all made us little necklaces with our names on them for the biology video. We were wearing a lot of red and black and accessorising with the red belts, very kind of hourglassy. And the necklaces were just kind of like a nice little finishing touch. Just personalised it a little bit more, and they made them in with our names on them as well, which is really sweet of them. I think we got to keep them. I think they're probably still in our stylist wardrobe. I don't just wear what I'm told, and I do have my own kind of style, and I think that's only really just really developed over the last couple of years. Even now, I'll look back even 3 years ago and go, oh my God, we didn't wear that, did we? Like little crop top and jeans and things like that, very girly. Okay, so that's me done for today. I hope you've picked up some helpful hints on how to accessorise. I'm off for my disco nap now. Choosing the right accessories can make or break an outfit and also boost your confidence, so make sure you choose wisely. I think you should spend more time in the mirror before you go out, the day before or a couple of hours before, so you're not rushing at the last minute. Make sure you have a special place for each and every part of your accessory drawer, so i.e. one for belts, one for bags and one for jewellery. Don't overload a small bag. Always have a big bag. They're very handy, especially like us when we're working quite long hours, to put absolutely everything you need in them.